Hi folks, Will from MinIO here, and in this video, we're gonna be working with MinIO Identity and Access Management. This is our lab companion video where we're gonna step you through the process of setting up users, groups, and policies, and we're also gonna show you how to connect to an LDAP server. Let's go ahead and dive right in. So let me start off by showing you what I've got set up right now. This is our MinIO platform, and I've got this set up running the default username and password. Our admin password is MinIO admin. And as you can see, I've got a very simple setup here right now. I've got a single bucket that has two objects in it, but I can see the bucket, I can see the objects. And also notice here on the left-hand side, I can scroll through and see all kinds of administrator tools that I need to use to work with my MinIO platform. Now, if I left this as it is, this would be the only user that's available on the system, and everybody would have to log in, everybody would have full access to the system using this process. So we don't want that. So what we're gonna do is we're going to actually set up some additional users and we're gonna set up some additional policies. So let's go ahead and take a look at that. First off, I'm gonna go ahead and add a user to my system. I don't have any right now. So if I do an mcadmin user list on MinIO 1, no users are available. Now, partly this is because there are no users that have been set up, but also that MinIO admin user that we're using right now, even as part of my mcadmin alias, is not actually controlled by MinIO IDP. So what we need to do is we need to set up an additional user. So we're gonna do an mcadmin user add MinIO 1, and we're gonna go ahead and add this new user as new user. And we need a password, which has to be at least 8 characters, new pass 1. There we go. This now has a new user assigned to it. If we now log into our console with that new user and new pass 1, what we see is all of those administrator functions are now gone on the left-hand side. And you saw that there's a bucket, but my user does not have any policy associated with it, which means that the user is getting a default deny policy for everything. So they're not allowed to see that we have buckets. They're not allowed to create buckets. Notice that it's even telling you, please ask your MinIO administrator to grant you S3 list bucket and S3 list star permissions in order to view the buckets on this server. I cannot do anything with this user. It has no permissions on the system. Let's go ahead and fix that. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take a look at the policies that we have available. If we do an mcadmin policy list MinIO 1, you'll see that we have the 5 built-in policies. Console admin is like the root user. We're not gonna assign that to our new user. Diagnostics is really used with subnet, so we're not gonna worry about diagnostics right now. Read-only, read-write, write-only, those would be the ones that we probably wanna take a look at. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna give this user read-write access to the system. And the way that you do this is with the MinIO command line, mcadmin policy attach MinIO 1. Read-write is the policy name we're going to use, and we need to tell it the user is new user, like so. So we now have this read-write policy attached to our new user. If we go ahead and take a look back on our console, now we can actually see that we have the bucket, we have the actual objects that we had uploaded before, and they're all there now because we can actually use this read-write tool. I can even do a list of buckets. I can even get here under monitoring, I have access to set up bucket watches. Okay, so this gives me at least read write capabilities on the system. So that is setting up a new user and that is adding a policy to that user. Now, if we're gonna manage policies on a user by user basis, that's gonna get really tedious very quickly. So MinIO gives us the power to use groups. And a group is really just a collection of users that all share the same policies. So any user of that group will have the policies that are assigned to the group. Now, I can still assign policies to an individual user. If I assign specific policies like I just did to my new user, those policies are going to take precedence over any group policies. So we'll go ahead and take a look at that. So let's go ahead and start off with an mcadmin group list on MinIO. And notice there aren't any, again, just like there weren't any users before, now there aren't any groups either. So we're gonna create a new group called browsers, mc admin group add minio1. We're going to call the group browsers, and we're going to add my new user. Now, when I create a group, I have to give it at least one user to begin with every single time. So I have now added this member new user to the group browsers quite successfully. And what we're going to do now is we're going to do an mc admin group info minio1 browsers to get some info about the group. Now, what do we see? Well, the group name is browsers. The status is enabled. I can enable and disable group. It has no policies associated with it. And it has this one member new user. So this new user is now part of the group. And you might expect, well, it's got no policies, so it can't do anything. Well, no, because my new user still has read-write. Let me go ahead and attach the read-only policy to the browser's group. So mc admin policy attach minio1 read-only group browsers. So what have I done there? Well, I'm attaching a policy. I'm attaching the read-only policy, as you can see from my read-only policy item up there under my policy list. And I'm going to attach this to the group browsers, like so. I have now successfully attached this to the group browsers. If I go ahead and get that info one more time, there it is. Policy is read-only. Now, the policy is read-only. My member is new users. Let's go back to the console. And here in the console, if I click on my object browser and I click on my bucket list, well, I can still see everything. Now, that's actually not what I should be able to do if I'm on read-only. Read-only will not allow me to list this bucket information, so I shouldn't be able to see this screen. Now, the issue here is that I have both this user policy that I've set, which is going to take precedence over the group policy. So that read-write policy is still in enforcement here. Let's go back and we're going to remove read-write from the new user. So let's go ahead and do an mc admin user info minio1 new user. And there we can see that we still have that policy of read-write on this user, even though they're a member of browsers. So what we want to do is get rid of that policy info by detaching the read-write. So we're going to do an mc admin policy. Detach this time, minio1, and that's the read-write policy, and we are detaching it from the user, new user. Okay, so our read-write is now successfully detached from new user. If I do the info one more time, now it shows that there's no policy name, but since we are a member of browsers, we will get the policies from browsers, and the one policy that we have in browser is, again, just that read-only. So let's go back to our console. Well, suddenly I can't actually see the objects in the bucket. This is what read-only does. I can't list anything. I can see that I have a bucket, and if I knew what the objects were, I could actually get those objects because I'm allowed to read the objects. But I can't list this bucket. So I can see the bucket, I can see it has two objects, but I can't list it. Okay? So I would have to know what the object names are. My access here is read. Now, since read access is one of our built-ins and read write's another one of our built-ins, there's actually a bit of a gap between those two levels. And we may want to fill that in just a little bit so that we're not giving too many permissions to any one person. And that's what we're going to do in our next lab is we're going to set up a custom policy. But that's going to be in our next video. So let's take a break right here. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you'd like to reach out with us, you can use any of the methods that you see here on the screen. You can also chat with us interactively on slack.min.io or just leave a comment here on the video. Thanks, and we'll see you for the next one.